Hello everyone. In the last lecture, we have discussed regarding the introduction to the TMS processor. And now onwards, let us try to understand the data addressing modes of the TMS processors. As usual, this also offers the certain addressing modes, such as immediate addressing mode, absolute addressing mode, accumulator addressing mode, direct, indirect, memory map register addressing mode, and stack addressing modes. Now let us try to analyze the first type of addressing mode, that is immediate addressing mode. Before going to start with the immediate addressing mode, let us first recall the definition of the addressing mode. We all know that the addressing mode definition is the way in which the operand is specified. First addressing mode is immediate addressing mode. In this addressing mode, an immediate data will be a part of the instruction. Here we are having two types of instructions with respect to the immediate addressing mode. The immediate operand may be short in length, such as 3, 5, 7, 8 or 9 bits in length. Called as short operands. Okay, and the next operand may be 16 bit in length. 16 bit in length, that is called as long word. Long word, and this can be written as short word. If the word is short operand, if it contains any, if the immediate operand contains in terms of a 3 bit, 5 bit, 7, 8 or 9 bits in length, then that type of instruction syntax will require one memory location. It occupies one memory location. If the data word is 16 bit in length or 16 bit wide, then this requires two memory locations. One memory location for short syntax, short operand instruction syntax, and two memory locations for long operand instructions. You have to note one thing here, that is, if in case it is a 16 bit or long word, then we know that we require two memory location. The two memory location should be consecutive in nature. It occupies two consecutive memory location, rather than selecting one from one memory location and giving some discontinuity and then taking the next memory location. That is not the case. It takes two consecutive memory locations. This addressing mode is used to initialize the data pointers or memory locations, or to initialize the register values. Now let us see some examples for the immediate addressing mode. These are the two instructions. In the first instruction, the immediate value is indicated by an immediate symbol, that is ash symbol. Here ash 20 comma DP, this means an immediate value 20 will be moved to, or will be, the immediate value 20 will be assigned to the data pointer. That means the memory location is been fixed with respect to the value 20. In the second case, you can see the value 0FFH is a part of the register RC. RPT refers to repeat instruction. Here we are repeating a certain instruction a certain number of times. by how many number of times? Double F, double FH, that is in hexadecimal. If you convert that into decimal, that means it is going to take value of 65,535. 65,535 times we are going to repeat a certain instruction, that immediate value is loaded, that is going to incorporate with a repeat counter. RC refers to the repeat counter. Repeat counter. We are loading that value 65,535 in decimal, double F, double F, H in case of hexadecimal, to a register called as repeat counter. Okay. The next addressing mode is absolute addressing mode. Absolute addressing. In this mode, the instruction contains the specific address of the operand. For example, the operand address is with respect to the program memory, with respect to PMAD addressing, or address confining to the data memory addressing, or port address capability we have in case of the TMS processor, and the star LK, that is with respect to the direct memory location, that is a part of a data memory space, that is star LK denotes the direct memory address. It can take any one of the four types of addressing. These are all the examples pertaining to the absolute addressing mode. The term absolute here refers to the specific address is allotted to a register. In this case, first one, MVKD, this refers to the DMAD addressing, that is data memory addressing. MVPD refers to PMAD addressing, that is program memory addressing. And this one, port R, this refers to the port addressing, port. And this one, LD star, the address is directly given within the bracket. If the value is within the bracket, it is confined to the direct addressing mode, that is direct star LK addressing. Now let us see how the operation is going to be performed in each and every instruction. In the first case, a specific value 1000H will be assigned to the register AR3. That means we are assigning a value, specifically a address, which is 1000H, to a register AR3. In the second case, we are assigning 2000 value, 2000H, to the register AR5. 2000 H will be assigned to the register AR5. Next, this is with respect to the port addressing. Port R refers to what? We are interested in reading a data from a specific port. Okay, instead of R, if you have W, that means port W, that means we are writing a data into a port. Here, we are assigning 05H as the address to the register AR1. 05H is being assigned to AR1. Next, LD star 1008H, A. This means the address here is 1008H, which is directly given because of brackets. The value is enclosed within the brackets. If that is the case, this value becomes the direct address. This direct address will be assigned to the accumulator. 1008H will be assigned to the accumulator. Here, we are assigning the address for the operand in the absolute addressing mode. Next addressing mode is accumulator addressing. In this mode, we are going to assign the value of the accumulator to a operand as the address. Okay. Here what we are doing, we are assigning the contents of the accumulator as the address. The contents of the accumulator will be treated as the address, and then that address is used to transfer the data from a program memory location to data memory location and vice versa. We can, since we know that the TMS processor offers memory to memory data transfer between memory to memory is possible. Data transfer between memory to memory is possible. One type of memory is program memory location, that is with respect to PMAD. Another type is DMAD, data memory addressing. We can interchange the information between program memory and data memory. Or in other words, we can say that here memory to memory data transfer is possible. Okay. In order to achieve this addressing mode, we are going to use two types of instructions, that is read and read A and write A. Okay. We are going to make use of two instructions, that is read A and write A, for transferring the data from one memory to another memory. Now let us see the examples. The instruction is read A star AR2. This refers to that we are going to transfer the data from program memory location to data memory location with assigning the contents of accumulator as the address to the specified register. Here what we are doing, we are assigning the address for AR2 with the value associated with the contents of accumulator. This accomplished, star A will be treated, star A, the contents of the accumulator is treated as address for star AR2. Suppose if A had a value of 50H, then before execution, after execution, what happens? This 50H, which was in the accumulator, will now be treated as an address for AR2. After execution, AR2 address will be 50H. That means what? In read instruction, what happens? This transfers a word from program memory location to a data memory location. Transfers a word from program memory location to data memory location. Next, let us consider write A star AR3. The instruction is write A star AR3. In this case, what we are going to do, we are writing a data. Okay, we are writing a data. That means we are transferring a data from data memory location to program memory location. In previous case, we have transferred data from program memory location to data memory location. In this case, we are performing the inverse. That is, we are transferring a word from data memory location to program memory location. Here, as usual, let us assume 54H was the content of accumulator. Now that 54H will be treated as the address for the register AR3. You can write 54H. But here we are transferring the data from data memory location to program memory location. If you transfer a word from program memory location to data memory location, that is treated as read operation. If you transfer a word from data memory location to program memory location, that becomes write operation. Okay. Next addressing mode is direct addressing mode. In direct addressing mode, we are going to generate the 16-bit address with the help of a DAGEN. We already know that DAGEN refers to Data Address Generation Unit. Here, our aim is to generate a 16-bit address with respect to two cases, with the help of the CPL, the compiler mode bit, that is CPL. If the CPL is equal to 0, then the effective address is treated with respect to the concatenating the DP value, that means concatenating the DP value of higher 9 bits with offset of the IR, that is with respect to the data memory address of a particular instruction register, particular instruction with considering only the 7 LSBs from the instruction register, the direct memory address, the data memory address, and rest of the 9 bits will be concatenated with respect to the value stored in the data page pointer. That means we can write like this. Lower 7 bits from IR, the next 9 bits from data page pointer. Here what we are doing, we are concatenating, we are combining the 9 bits from the DP and 7 bits from the IR, and then we are going to generate a 16-bit address. That is 9 plus 7, we are going to get a 16-bit address. That's why we are given the EA is equal to DP colon offset. In the next case, if the compiler mode bit is equal to 1, then effective address is calculated with the stack pointer. Data pointer when CPL is equal to 0, stack pointer comes into picture if CPL is equal to 1. Here, instead of concatenating, what we are going to do, we are going to add the offset value, we are going to add the offset value pertaining to the instruction register. If that is the case, I have to fix the SP by default as 16 bit itself. That is not in the case with respect to DP, because we are getting 7 bits from the IR, the remaining 9 bits is filled by DP, so we have to write DP 9, here SP 16. Along with the SP, if you want to add any offset, then what happens? That much of address is added, and then it can take 16-bit address itself, or the width can double with respect to another address bus, that is CAB, that leads to read a 32-bit data. Because of, you know that 3 memory spaces are available for data memory. In this case, we are making use of only 2 memory space. With respect to one bus, data bus, another one is also data bus, the additional data bus is EB. One more data bus is there, that is CB. That data bus is not been used in this case of data address generation of a direct memory address. The whole aim is to generate a 16-bit address with respect to two aspects. One, by considering the data page pointer, and then concatenating the rest of the 7 bits from the IR, 9 bits from DP and 7 bits from the IR. And next, 16-bit value from the SP and another 16-bit value from the IR are added, and then a new 16-bit or a new 32-bit address is generated in the second case for CPL. Now let us consider the example for the direct addressing mode. In this example, we are treating CPL is equal to 0. Treating CPL is equal to 0 means what? We are interested in generating the address with respect to DP and not with respect to SP. Add the contents of the memory location 0 on page 4. That means we are referring to page 4. There are 128 pages. Out of 128 pages, we are referring to fourth page. Okay, we are referring to fourth page. In that fourth page, we are interested in selecting the memory location 0. For what purpose? To add. Okay, on page 4 in the data memory to accumulator B. That means that contents of memory location 0, any value which is already being there in memory location 0 will be added with respect to the value containing in the accumulator B. In order to do so, these two are the instructions we are going to see. That is, first we have to use LD for the purpose of load data page pointer, and we are referring to the fourth page out of 128 pages. For that purpose, I am using #4 and I am using immediate addressing mode, comma DP. This gives the information that DP is assigned a value of 4. Along with that, the upper 9 bits of the address are taken into consideration. Because we know that the 16-bit address is computed with the concatenation of 9 bits from the DP and 7 bits from the instruction register. Okay. And next instruction is add is equal to 0. That means we are performing addition with respect to memory location 0. With respect to memory location 0, for that purpose, add is equal to 0. We are directly mentioning which address. We are mentioning here the location 0. With what? With the accumulator B. We also know that we have two accumulators in case of our TMS processor. That is, one accumulator is A, the additional accumulator is B, each of 40 bit wide. Lower 7 bits of the address. Lower 7 bit of the address will be concatenated with respect to the upper 9 bits of the DP, and then the 16-bit address is formed. Address is generated with the help of these two instructions. Next type of addressing mode with respect to the TMS processor is indirect addressing mode. In indirect addressing mode, any data in the data space can be accessed indirectly by means of auxiliary registers. The TMS processor offers 8 16-bit auxiliary registers, that is from AR0 to star AR0 to star AR7, along with the two ARAU units. What do you mean by ARAU? Auxiliary register arithmetic units. Auxiliary register arithmetic unit 0, and the other one is ARAU1. We have two auxiliary register arithmetic units. Any register content can be modified from AR0 to AR7 with the help of these two additional arithmetic units, that is auxiliary register arithmetic unit 0 and auxiliary register arithmetic unit 1. The need for the indirect addressing mode arises when we want to access the data in terms of certain number of steps with respect to memory location. If you want to step in terms of a fixed step with respect to the memory location, accessing the data with respect to memory location in terms of certain steps, then we have to choose indirect addressing mode. Okay. As I said before, we are going to make use of the ARAU0 and ARAU1 in order to modify the address register, that is auxiliary address register. We have 8 auxiliary address register, that is from AR0 to AR7. In this ARAU0, we are seeing that we are having the modification is with respect to AR0, the basic register, that is AR0, and BK. Here the term BK refers to the step size. BK is equal to step size or buffer size. Buffer size. Here BK is equal to buffer size in case of circular addressing mode, and L indicating long operand, 16 bits, and LK denotes the direct addressing mode, direct address. Then plus bar minus indicates whether the enhancement. Here the plus bar minus gives the information with respect to the various enhancement, that is, if it is plus, increment; if it is minus, decrement. Increment the address, minus decrement. And here the percent symbol indicates the, it gives the information that the addressing mode is circular addressing mode. Circular addressing mode with respect to modulo addition. And zero here refers to the default address register is AR0. AR0. And term B indicates the special addressing mode, that is, bit reverse addressing mode is used. B is equal to bit reversed addressing mode. This is the second unit. Here also we have increment, decrement, circular addressing mode, AR0, long word, buffer size, and AR0. That means we have to start from AR0. Out of 8 auxiliary registers, we are going to start with respect to AR0, with respect to both the auxiliary register arithmetic units. Now let us try to work out some of the examples associated with respect to the indirect addressing mode. Now let us try to analyze the problem statement first. The problem is, assuming the current contents of AR3 to be 200H, what will be its contents after each of the following TMS320C54XX addressing mode is used? Assume AR0 is equal to 20H. The first problem is star AR3 plus 0. The first problem is star AR3 plus 0. That means indirect addressing mode associated with respect to the auxiliary register R3, this content will be added to the 0. We all know that 0 indicates what? AR0. If that is the case, I can write AR3 is equal to AR3 plus AR0. I can write AR3 is equal to 200 plus AR0 is equal to 20. With that, it becomes 220H. Okay. In second case, AR3 minus 0. That means AR3 will be updated to AR3 minus AR0. That is equal to 200 minus 20. That is equal to 1E0H. 1E0H. Next is star AR3 plus. That means increment operation. That means AR3 is simply AR3 plus 1. I know that AR3 is equal to 200. 200 plus 1, that is equal to 201H. In next case, it is decrement operation. AR3 tends to AR3 minus 1, that is equal to 200. H minus 1, that is equal to 1FFH. Next, star AR3. Here there is no modification. Why? There is no any symbol, that is, with respect to plus, minus, or B percent, zero, nothing has been given. That means AR3 remains as it is. AR3 will not be modified, no change. No change, AR3 remains 200 H itself. In this case, star plus AR3 contents of star plus AR3 bracket of 40H. That means here the 40H is the offset value that is going to add to the AR3 pre-add offset. That means AR3 written as AR3 plus 40H. That means AR3 is 200 plus 40, that is 240H. Next is pre-subtract, pre-add offset. Here we have to take care of one thing, that is pre-add offset, that is not pre-subtract offset, because before auxiliary register we are having plus symbol, not minus symbol. Inside the bracket we are having minus, but it belongs to pre-add offset because the plus sign is associated with respect to AR3. Then I can write AR3 can be equal to AR3 minus 40H, and that gives 200H minus 40H, that gives to 1C0H. Now let us consider minus instead of plus. Then what happens? Pre-subtract offset. Then AR3 becomes AR3 minus, because of pre-subtract, minus of minus 40H. Then minus into minus, plus. Once again, this becomes AR3 plus 40H. Here in case of minus is present here, if the minus is present here, then what happens? The answer is 240H, and that becomes pre-subtract offset. Okay, thank you.